A greeting, Scorpio, and welcome to Ingrid's Insights. I hope you're all doing wonderfully well, and thank you so much for subscribing to my channel and helping it grow. And to my new viewers, welcome, and to those who are coming back, so happy to see you again. And this is what the oracles have for us, a balance, Scorpio, where you're coming into a time where it's important right now with the number 14. Could be very important, could mean something to you significantly. But 14, and that 1 in 4 is 5, so there could be a sense of moving in this balanced way right now. And that's beautiful for you, Scorpio, because fear, serenity, number 8. So you are using this fear, serenity. You're being serene, the serenity prayer. Lord, grant me the wisdom to know the difference between what I can change and what I cannot change. And that's the balance you're coming toward for my Scorpio in this reading today. And thank you so much for joining in. And thank you, Spirit Guides, for overseeing this reading for my Scorpio, Sun, Moon, and Rising. And my name is Ingrid. And I'm so blessed to be doing this reading for you. I'm always so thrilled to see what is this coming up for my Scorpio. And so it is. And let's get the cards out. This wanted to come out right off the bat, the Ten of Cups, where you're recognizing that whatever you've been alchemizing in the realm of your heart and working on and cooking and the furnace of your passions, you're balancing that, and you're finding some serenity in that, and you're coming to this recognition of happiness, of bliss, of happy relationships, of a time of fulfillment after maybe a difficult go at things. But you are heating it up, raising the flames, cooking something up that's going to bring you a bliss, happiness, a happy family, a happy home life, just love around you. Because you have the Nine of Wands. Well, you've been resilient. You've been standing up for this. You've been fighting for this. This is something that you have been maybe wounded in your heart, in your body. Very defensive about this happiness. Maybe you feel this happiness at some point was something that was not making you very serene. You were not feeling in balance. You were feeling out of balance and defensive. And somehow you're cooking, burning, transmuting this wolf, this battler, this warrior into something that is going to help you balance, because you've got the opportunity at the foundation. And you see this rabbit is about abundance, fruition, productivity. And unlike the rabbit's foot, good luck to take this opportunity and grow it and plant it. Something about gardening, bringing something into fruition through your hands, through working in the earth. But also it's just like being smart about your money right now. And that is somehow being defensive about your happiness is the challenge, but also being resilient about being happy, because you stand up for your happiness. You're standing your ground at all costs, and there's money, there's abundance at the foundation, because something has recently came to an end. There was a death, a completion. You maybe had seen this coming for a while, and then it finally had this long drawn out end. But it could have been that something had to come to an end, a relationship, a situation, a phase of life. So this new opportunity can come, and you can let go of, let's see what it is that's ending in your past. Give us some, we'll get clarity on this, but something is needing to die so something can be reborn at the crown. You're a Nine of Cups, Well, whatever this is, you're coming into the Nine of Cups. You've got the Ten of Cups and then the Nine. And these are water signs, like you, Scorpio. There's a lot of fulfillment. You might have, something came to an end and you wished, you put that out there. And a lot of abundance came in, happiness, a partying, self-care, enjoyment, indulging yourself. Because something ended recently and you're now, right now, you're the Nine of Swords. You're feeling like you're having to do Tai Chi or some martial arts under these dangling nightmares. There are nine of them that are hanging over your head, like, when is the next sword going to fall? The swords are saying that you're worrying about something, you're paranoid about something, you're upset mentally, and you're going over and over. It could be that you're worrying about somebody else, that there was an end to a relationship. And even though you felt like it was a wish fulfillment that it ended, there's something that's still a residue of paranoia, of worry, of anxiety, of feeling like that catastrophizing. And you see the Two of Pentacles. Well, see, that's that mathematical sign of the Lemniscate, which is the infinity sign. And that's saying you have infinite ability to change and adapt and deal with your money to bring you happiness and success and bliss and abundance. That you are doing that. That's how you see your happiness. It's something that you have to juggle. That spiritual and the physical, the material and the more internal processes, because this could deal with someone in your environment is the Emperor, someone who you're dealing with is very in control of their, it could be an Aries, but it doesn't have to be, but it's just saying someone is in your environment you feel very connected to, who's an authority, who's a leader, who has a lot of foundational strength to command their own life and destiny. And that could be coming at you, perhaps, from your environment. Because the Seven of Swords is here in the hope and fear. Well, there's something about the Seven of Swords that can go both ways. One way is, I could see in the scenario, is that you had started off the question with something about this bliss, or something about being defensive about your happiness, defensive of fighting, of battling for happiness. And at the foundation, it is focusing on money is a problem, or is a situation, or something you can't see. This opportunity, this gift of growing something. But that came to an end recently. Whatever is, something's ending, a relationship, a situation, a phase of life. It could be a natural ending where someone is moving from being single to married, or from being a student to having a job. But there's something ending, but it's going to bring a lot of fulfillment. You've wished for this. But then somehow be careful what you wish for, because what is coming right now for you to see, Scorpio, is this paranoia. There's something you're worrying about, somebody, something about this death, this ending. And you're having to juggle this situation financially. Maybe it's something that you're worrying about your wealth, worrying about this opportunity, and having to be very adaptable and flexible and juggle your money. You know, take money from here to give there. And the advice is the Seven of Wands. Well, you're going to have to keep on fighting. Keep standing up. Keep going. Keep believing in yourself. There's competition. You know, it's energetically, you're going to have to just keep going. And that's the challenge to your happiness. But it's also the advice up here is you have to kind of keep going, have valor, believe in yourself, find that balance. You've got the card of balance, and then you've got, this is the card of having to balance and juggle. And then, so let's get some clarity and see what it is that the tarot cards have for us, Scorpio. Why is the Ten of Cups here as your, this is what you're thinking about. This is the energy around you right now. And it's the Knight of Wands. You're going fast and furiously with a lot of a cocky energy toward your happiness, with passion, with sexuality, with your intuition. You're thinking, well, my knight is going to get me what I want, and I want happiness. And I've been fighting for it and standing up and being defensive because I'm now evaluating that position. Do I need to appraise my tactics? I can appraise and look over what I've created. You've worked hard at this. But do you want to keep going on in that same way? Or do you want to plant the seed, this new opportunity? Because that's coming, and it's going to make you the Empress, very abundant, very nurturing. This is the Great Mother. So it could be dealing with mothering issues of nurturing money, this new opportunity to nurture your abundance and be very successful and beautiful at doing that, a prosperous, creative. Maybe you need to be creative about how you take this new opportunity, because something ended recently. The Ten of Swords, whatever this is, this defeat, this despair, this hitting rock bottom, this feeling abused, betrayed, a trauma, a death that in the past caused this trauma. But you're coming to the end, a new beginning, because both of these cards are saying that something is coming to an end, but there is a new dawn coming in both of these cards. And it's going to, the higher powers want you to know that your wish is coming true. When this ends, this mental despair, this conflict, this defeat, this upset, this ending, it's going to bring you happiness quickly, and you're going to go for it. It's going to be a lot of communication. It's going to make you go for it, travel, move. You got the green light to move toward the sun, to shine clarity on whatever this worry is, this paranoia, this nightmare. You're healing from that. You have optimism, a renewal of energy. And you've been balancing that because you've been getting some information from the High Priestess, using your dreams, your intuition, your psychic abilities. And the Emperor is here because of a judgment call. Well, you're waking up to something in your environment about the Emperor, about this, it could be a man or a woman, but this masculine, competent leadership energy that goes and that rules and over things and is very powerful. And that you're waking up to that in your environment. There's some judgment call you have to make about this Emperor. In your environment, there is a wake-up call coming, and it will change everything. Think, you know, you're rising up out of the dead. It's almost like a new life is coming from this Emperor, from the boss, from the father figure, because of you're taking this energy out, this kind of lying, cheating, and deceiving energy as the hope and fear. You might want to be diplomatic, have some strategy and tactics of how you move out into the world, and you might not be telling people about it. This is a card of trickery, and you see the fox is a very cunning, very tricky. You're stealing your hope and fears that you can steal, lie, cheat to get the upper hand, to manipulate. This is a card that can be very narcissistic, going for what you want, deceiving, downright stealing. So watch out in your environment. If there's something you're planning, some idea you have that you're taking out there, don't tell anybody. You better be quiet, because, or you might be trying to deceive someone about that. But it's leading to a judgment call in your environment. And you're going to have to keep on believing in yourself and standing up, and there's still going to be a competition, because you're going to be victorious over that. Whatever that that you've been fighting for, standing your ground, your valor, your victory is coming, and you're going to have people see you on the high horse. You're going to be standing in the limelight. You're going to be victorious because let's see. This is amazing. How are you going to be victorious? Let's get one final question to clarify that from the angel oracles. Where is this? What is this victory about for Scorpio? What is this victory about for Scorpio? Communicate clearly. Well, whatever it is you're going for and being victorious about or want to be, you need to communicate clearly. Don't be deceptive about your plans. You need to let people know, and to not lie or steal or deceive, because that is not communicating clearly. And so that's what I have. And if this resonates for you, Scorpio, please subscribe right now and give me a thumbs up and push that notification bell, so every time I do your readings, which I do every other day, you will get this information and to see where you're going with all of this. It's coming in triumphantly. You're going to be recognized. You're going to be successful at this. And so it is. And you know I love you. And we're in this interconnected field where this sacred information is made available to us. So let me know how this works for you. Bye-bye.